So today we're going to be looking at the Game Deus Aura GC1 Elite. It retails for about $60 on Amazon, putting it in the budget category as far as full-size ATX cases. You can fit pretty much any consumer-grade motherboard in there, with a graphics card that's up to 340 millimeters in length, and a CPU cooler up to 155 millimeters in height from the motherboard. But the case fans came with the case. There are four 120 millimeter fans. You have three intakes along the front, and you have one 120 millimeter exhaust out back. They're each powered by a single Molex connector, and while they don't make very much noise, move plenty of air for a system that you would want to put in this case. This is actually my personal system here, with a Ryzen 5 5600 and a RX 588 graphics card that outputs a lot of heat and doesn't have the best fans available to it as far as what's on the card itself. And going to a mesh front panel from the drive cage mess that was my old case did bring it up to acceptable level of performance. These fans are not the best fans in the world, but they do their job for a case in this price bracket, and I would rather see cheap fans and good build quality than a crappy case with a lot of fans. Because you can replace the fans a lot cheaper than you can replace the case. You can pick up six 120mm fans for like $20 that'll blow these out of the water and have ARGB function. Now, instead of having the fixed lighting that we have here. The black version does include black fans instead of these white ones. We can't vouch for the color matching of metal to plastic on the black version, but here on the white version, which is typically the more challenging color, it is done very well. Between the metal top here and the plastic front panel, which comes off with alligator clips. If we rotate this thing to the side, you can clearly see, if you don't already, this has a full tempered glass side panel that removes with these four thumb screws. As you can see, it is tremendously dirty in there. Believe me, I've tried cleaning it. And every time I try to, it just makes it worse. It didn't ship like that. It was clean when I got it, but by the time I put the computer in it and everything, it turned out to be very dirty. It has a full 7 slots, which is what you'd expect from a full-sized ATX motherboard. They are the break-off variety of PCI slot covers, so once you break them off, they're done. You have to fill in an empty slot. You're going to have to either find or buy some slot covers. I would highly recommend you buy some white ones upon purchase if you can, if you ever end up needing them. The power supply has a filtered intake in the bottom. It has a piece of mesh that kind of clips in there. It's not the most well-designed thing. It doesn't even have like a tray where you can just like pull it out. Instead, you kind of have to turn the case on its side. I strongly recommend you do the metal. You turn it onto the metal side panel down, not the glass one. And you can remove the power supply filtered that way. There are no sharp edges to be found in this case. As you can see, I currently have a band-aid on my finger because I was working on an HP Envy system that had a razor sharp piece of metal in it right next to the PCI slot. It has plenty of cable cutouts. It's got the 24-pin cutout there, a 4-pin cutout up there for CPU power. Well, technically you can run any power cable through there, but I just only have the 4-pin for my motherboard. It has cutouts along this edge for things like front panel, USB 2, USB 3 up there, your audio, things like that. If we go up to the top, and we'll cut to a separate shot of the top for this clip, you can see that it has two USB 2.0 ports and one USB 3.0 port, separate headphone and microphone jacks, as well as your power reset switch and power and hard disk activity LED. This case can fit four 2.5-inch drives, or you can change out two of those 2.5-inch drives or 3.5-inch drives, because it has two bays that can be either 2.5 or 3.5-inch in the bottom in the power supply shroud, I'm actually going to take the metal side panel off to show you that. Comes with these two thumb screws to hold the metal one on. It is among similar to the old style clip, a variety. But as you can see, it only has the clips along this edge here, compared to having them all along the top and bottom. So as long as you use your zip ties wisely, and I apologize I didn't trim these. But as long as you use your zip ties wisely, you can get this panel on pretty easy. I do have a semi-modular power supply, which makes it easier because I only have one SATA drive in my system. If we move the cables out of the way, you'll see the one SATA hard drive that attaches to the top of this cage, and then you can mount another one in the cage. And it obviously has all the screw holes for that. But you can also do two and a half inch drives in this, or you can mix a 3.5 and a 2.5. You can see the screws for the
2.5 inch drive mounts on the motherboard tray.
You're going to need to install them with the connectors facing towards this hole, because that's where your cable management is. And you might end up having to use straight connectors rather than a front angle, which would look a little bit nicer depending on whether or not you have two drives in there or how far off the drive the right angle connector is. We have a cutout in the back of the motherboard, a very large, but otherwise nothing special about it. You can use it to access your cooler back plate, so you can change your cooler without removing the motherboard from the case. I would highly recommend you do that. It does come with the standoff needed for mini ITX, micro ATX, and full-sized ATX. I have a micro ATX board here that's not as long as a typical micro ATX. That's why these standoffs here don't actually have anything in them, because the board doesn't extend this far. You can see the power supply here, with the fan facing the bottom, with the filter that I talked about earlier. You can turn it around and have the fan facing upwards, and there is mesh in the, show you here, power supply shroud for the fan to get air from inside your case. That's obviously not gonna do as well for power supply thermals, but if you're concerned about having a bottom intake, let's say you have carpet or something, which you should really put your computer like up on a table, even if it's just a couple feet high, compared to just having it sit on the carpet, because you get a lot of dust intake. This case doesn't have much of a dust filter for these three intake fans in the front, and it just trashes your the dust just trashes your airflow. You get pet hair if you have pets, especially ones that shed a lot, and it's just a mess. That you're gonna notice through this tempered glass window that I have a love-hate relationship with. It did have a peel on both sides, but as you can see, it is just dirty from all the particles that are in this room and end up getting sucked into the fans, and then it ends up sticking to the side panel, or it sits on the back of the graphics card on the back plate, which doesn't look particularly good. Speaking of the graphics card, this case has no vertical mounts, and I wouldn't recommend using them for an air-cooled GPU anyway, which is what you're going to be installing in this case if you're buying a $60 case. Because most likely, if you have a water-cooled GPU, you can stretch for a higher quality case, but I would not recommend putting an air-cooled vertical mount GPU in this case, even if you found one of those like weird adapter things and used a riser, because that would potentially, depending on how far back it sets, run into issues with the glass here. It might look better. I objectively think it does, but you're gonna run into problems with airflow if it sits too close to this glass here. The motherboard tray has a reasonable amount of flex in it without the motherboard installed. Once you have the motherboard installed in the case, it's not really budging much at all, really. Unlike the top, which even just slightly pressing down on it with one finger does kind of make it bow in a little bit. Granted, there's no fans in there to support this thing, but it also doesn't come with them. So if you're gonna end up setting things heavy on top of this case, which, by the way, top fan mounts do have a filter, it's magnetic, it covers all the It covers all of them. It just kind of hangs out up there. It's resistant to the case. But if you set things heavy up there, you're going to end up having the top of your computer look like this before long. These fans don't have any filter on them. It's just the mesh, which provides a decent amount of airflow. There is a gap through the sides, but because the fans mounted to the outside of the case, it doesn't really contribute to airflow. All of it just is coming in the front, unless you block the front with your hand. And then you can feel some go through the side, but that's not how it's intended. It's not how, under normal operation, it would work. That's what I wanted to make a video about. I covered all the points that I wanted in this case. I think it's a very good option in the $50-$60 range, which is about as low as you should go for cases. Cases below this price point, or not objectively, you're saving like 10, 20 bucks. And you're getting a much worse case. You're probably looking at Micro ATX. You end up with less fans, a much cheaper materials quality that ultimately leads to the case being replaced sooner when it doesn't have to. So that's my look at the Aura GC1 Elite. I hope you all have a wonderful day. That I'm going to put links in the description to buy this case if you do in fact want to purchase it. This is Bryce Just Tech here, signing off for this video.